If you want to earn $250,000 a year in tech sales in 5 years, this is how you do it. How many creators do you know that can earn that amount of money in that amount of time? Do you think you'd be able to in your current job? If not, then why not consider a career in tech sales? I have over 10 years of sales experience and over 5 years of tech sales experience for one of the biggest cybersecurity companies in the world, Cloudflare, and I'm gonna share the industry knowledge I've acquired so you can get there too and earn more from your job than you ever thought was possible.
Oh my God! Wow!
According to RepView.com, 250K is the average on-target earnings for an enterprise account executive. Personally speaking, I could have been earning a lot more earlier because the mistake I made was not getting into tech sales sooner. A lot of people hear the word sales and they have this really negative connotation about it. You might still have so as well. You get this image of a used car salesman, someone who's manipulative, pushy, aggressive, not nice to deal with, a little bit shady, someone who's only looking after their own interest and only cares about the sale. That stereotype still exists today. Even when I tell people I'm in tech sales, all they hear is the word sales and not tech, and they think, ugh. And it's not entirely their fault, because everyone hates the feeling of being sold something you don't think you need or even want. It's the lack of transparency that comes with dealing with salespeople that always leaves you with your guard up. And you think to yourself, oh, I don't want to be that kind of person. I don't want to be in sales and be pushy with people. Even if you're not the kind of salesperson who's manipulative, there's still the fear of rejection that a lot of people don't like about sales. They don't want to be the ones emailing or cold calling people, getting loads of rejections day after day. You have to have a pretty thick skin to be able to deal with it.
No, God, please, no!
But that means a lot of people aren't as interested in tech sales, and that gives you a potential opportunity. Because sales is crucial in any business. It is the whole reason that a business is allowed to function. If you're working for a company that provides a product or a solution people really like, you'll also feel a lot better about talking to people about that product.
Nice.
Think about a brand you really enjoy. Apple, Patagonia, Mercedes-Benz. Maybe you wouldn't have the same feeling of being a salesperson if you were selling that brand instead, because you like that brand. You'd feel comfortable sharing and talking about it. You know other people like that brand. Therefore, you feel like, this could be something I could do.
Okay.
The trick is to find a tech company which is the same. It's a company that has a clear product market fit, people like it, and you feel good about selling that product or talking about that product to other people. That's how I currently feel in my role in cybersecurity. I know this is an essential function for any business. Cybersecurity isn't a want, it's a need. Therefore, I feel like I'm helping people every time I reach out to them and give them something they don't have. Help them to learn something new about their business. Don't make the mistake I made and think, sales? No, not for me. I'm gonna share how in 5 years, you could be earning $250,000 a year.
Yeah, boy, help me.
This 250K that an enterprise AE earns is usually broken down in a 50-50 split. 50% is the salary, 50% is the variable compensation, which means if you hit your quota, you will get that entire 50%. So when you hear 250K, think OTE, on target earnings. Obviously, to earn that 250K, you have to be a top performer. You have to be good at what you do. But the beauty of tech sales is 250K is the average, meaning if you exceed your quota, you'll earn even more than 250K. So if you're interested, the first thing you need to do is start at an entry-level role, a BDR or an SDR, which stands for Business Development Representative or Sales Development Representative. The purpose of the BDR is to qualify a prospect so it's worthy enough to be passed on to an AE. They'll qualify the prospect for budget, for need, timeline, and make sure they're speaking to the right person within the company as well. Once that lead is fully qualified, they'll pass it on to the AE. It's then the role of the AE to qualify that lead even further. They'll ask a few more discovery questions, provide a demonstration of the product itself, maybe even give them a proof of concept, a POC. The EE is also responsible for taking care of the commercial aspects, providing pricing, and then negotiating. The EE manages the entire relationship, brings in other people from the organization who can help close a deal, such as a solution engineer to help with the technical aspects, or someone senior, an executive in the company, to help build that relationship. Hopefully you'll get to the end where you can send out the contract and then get an electronic signature and sign the customer. That's what I did when I joined Cloudflare 6 years ago. I didn't really know much about this role and much about the industry of cybersecurity, but companies are always willing to look for people who are motivated self-starters. So don't think you need any prior experience, although obviously that helps. You just need to show a willingness to learn about the technology and a drive to keep going when times get tough. If you want to know where to begin, check out the Forbes Cloud 100 list. This is what I did when I first started. I just went through the entire list, went to every company's career page, and saw who was hiring for a BDR role in the city I was in. I also recommend going to repview.com. List the companies by the highest ranking. See who's hiring for a BDR role. Apply for all the roles. If there's some way you can differentiate yourself by showing you have an interest in that particular industry, that sets you apart even more. Once you get to the BDR role, you'll likely be one of three kinds of people: inbound BDR, self-serve BDR, or outbound BDR. Inbound BDRs deal with requests that are inbounded in from prospects. This can be emails or phone calls. These are the best kinds of leads because the prospect is already in a buying state of mind and they're interested to learn about your solution. They want you to pitch to them. The second type is self-serve BDR, leads who are existing customers of the company. They just use a lower tier plan, but they could reach out to you or you could reach out to them about a higher tier plan, typically the enterprise plan, which is a custom plan on a fixed contract. These customers are great because they already like you and they're already using you. So if you can justify the extra services you'll provide at the cost it's going to be, they'll be more than happy to pay. Then you have the hardest type of BDR, outbound BDR. These are your hunters. They're going out there and meeting people at industry events. They're cold calling. They're reaching out to people on LinkedIn. They're scouring news websites to see who's gotten funding. They're sending out loads of cold emails as well. This job is tough, and you have to be able to succeed at this job if you really think that you want to be an account executive, which is the next step up. Once you've proven yourself in the BDR role for about a year and a half, then you'll get promoted to an AE, an account executive. There are different types of AEs, and it will likely depend on the type of tech company you're at. If your product is an enterprise product, that doesn't necessarily mean you'll be selling to enterprise-grade customers. That just might be the name of that particular subscription for that company. Because if you're selling anything for under 30K a year, this typically means you're an SMB AE or a commercial AE. This average contract value, or ACV, means the kind of customers you're reaching out to or the kind of product you're selling isn't true enterprise grade. As a result, you won't be getting paid as much as an enterprise AE. These are the stepping stones you have to take to get to the enterprise AE level. You start at the SMB commercial AE level, then you take the next step to a mid-market AE. The average contract values of mid-market AEs typically range between 40 to perhaps 150K per year. By now, you'll have gotten more comfortable with selling bigger size deals, longer sales cycles, and also more complex structures that you're selling into. The organizations you're dealing with are going to be bigger, which means you're going to have to identify the different stakeholders, speak to a number of different people within the company in order to get consensus that they're going to go ahead and buy your service. So to recap, you start at the BDR level, do that for a year and a half. You then get promoted to a SMB or commercial AE. You do that for another 2 years, then promoted to a mid-market AE, and you do that for another 2 years as well. By this time, you'll have been in a sales role for about 5 years. And if you've gotten all these promotions, you'll have proven yourself as a top performer as well. this is when you're going to be more qualified to apply for an enterprise AE role. You've got the track record to prove that you can sell, and you've consistently shown that you can go further and further up market to sell bigger deals with longer sales cycles to more complex organizations. Typically, that role requires at least 5 years of B2B SaaS sales experience. Once you're an enterprise AE, the sky's the limit. If you are a top performer, 250K is the average. People can earn more of their OTE. They can overachieve on their number, meaning the earning potential is uncapped. For example, if your quota for the year is $1 million and you sell $2 million, well, you could be earning $500,000 that year. Because for a lot of companies, if you go above your quota, they put something in place called an accelerator. They're trying to incentivize you to keep over-delivering on your number. Not only that, but tech companies will typically have some kind of employee stock program. This is especially lucrative if you manage to get very lucky and pick the right kind of company, in which you get stock options before the company has gone public. By the time they IPO, you get to reap the benefits. This is how people get ridiculously rich in tech. Don't make the mistake I made and think that sales is a dirty word. This is an extremely important and lucrative career. Sales is tough, but you won't be going through it alone. The best organizations will have some kind of sales enablement, training, certification, so that you are prepared to do your job. It's important to stick at it. Learn from other people in your company who are good at what they do. No need to reinvent the wheel. They'll tell you what works. The more time you spend in that company or your industry, the more confidence you'll get as well. You'll have to develop thick skin, and you'll have to not care about what other people think of you when you tell them that you work in tech sales. Be proud. You play an important role for the company, and it would not be able to exist without you. What you do directly impacts the bottom line, which means even when times are bad, if you can help deliver, you are extremely valuable to your company and they are not likely to let good salespeople go. What tech companies realize is if you're a successful AE at one company, you can be a successful AE at another company, even if the product, solution, and industry is entirely different, because the skills are transferable. All you need to do is learn the new product. Which means in this one role as an AE, there are countless opportunities for you all over the world in every single industry in tech. This is incredible. You can go from someone who has no degree, no qualifications, no previous experience, and earn on average $250,000 a year. There aren't many careers you can do that in. This channel is dedicated to helping get more people into tech sales. I think it's an incredible industry. I've been fortunate enough to reap the benefits of it at Cloudflare. I've gone through all the stages I've just described myself, and I think many people don't know about it. I want to build this channel and share videos of sales tips that will help to get them there faster. I don't want you to make the same mistakes I did. I'm going to share all my industry knowledge with you. If you have any questions about getting into tech sales, feel free to put them in the comments below. And if you like these sales tips, then I'll see you in our next one-on-one.